So the action steps, this self-reliant community stuff, people want regional banking, regional food, regional energy. Think what America would look like if we could, you know, we're going to have to pull this off. And people were actually talking green jobs. So, as one student in Fort Lewis said, that all looks really good. How come we don't have it? So I want to show this one last thing. In democracy, these are human values. This is, you know, our vision should count. If we want no more coal, we should have it. So the idea here is to grow our wealth by full cost accounting, triple bottom line stuff. You guys are probably hearing this in school. This is where you increase one form of capital without decreasing the other two. So what does oil do, you know? Decreases environmental capital. I mean, so it's right off the bat, you can't fit it into this equation. Okay, so welcome to the second part of the democracy crisis. Why don't our values count? If this is a democracy, how come we can't, our Congress can't deliver what it is that we want, okay? So this is what we're taught. This is the democracy that we're taught we have. Three branches of government, this is what we're taught, what, in middle school, for God's sakes? Legislature that makes the law, judiciary that interprets the law, executive branch that enforces the law, system of checks and balances, and the ultimate check and balance is we the people. And this is our sovereign self-governance, right? This is what we're taught, right? Okay, so this is Oz, okay? And we have this curtain that says democracy, and behind the curtain, somebody else is pulling the levers of our governance. So, when people in Cordova started asking this question, you know, how did corporations get this big, that they started ruling, basically, I went, you know, I don't know, that's a really good question. So I actually did 2 years of research and learned a heck of a lot, went all the way back to basically, you know, this is a democracy, what I'm saying here, there it should be. And we have lost the operating instructions, okay? We need to change the rules, or at the minimum, we need to be writing the rules, and this is not what's happening right now. So protest away, but it's time to get a little bit more serious about being in control. So let's go back and think about when our founders wrote that Constitution and they wrote, we the people, what exactly, who exactly were we the people, okay? Law, under law, people are considered natural persons. Humans are natural persons. There's two types of persons recognized under law. One is humans, us, natural persons. Now, common people did not have anything to do with writing the Constitution, right? So forget that. There goes 80% of the population. And here's the other 20%. So wealthy rule, ignore it. And if you haven't read the Constitution, you should. It will take you 10 minutes, okay? It's a commerce and property document. It was written by the wealthy minority who were trying to protect their wealth. It is a negative right document. Any human right that we want, we have to write it in, okay? And I forgot to mention that the word person is mentioned 34 times in this document. Now, it is such a commerce and property document that when it popped out on the street, it, you know, in Philadelphia and got around, everybody went, where are our rights? So there was a very hastily drafted Bill of Rights that got sort of appended, you know, to this negative rights document. And I also want to point out that this is all passed in the heat of the American Revolution. What happened after the American Revolution? We fought the money power and we fought the monarchy. So people had a huge distrust of big corporations, okay? So people kept a very tight control of them. Here's the other person under the law. That person is an artificial person. Boink. And the law, the Constitution, did not distinguish between natural persons and artificial persons. Why? Because our founders never dreamed we would have to. We fought an American Revolution over this. People, you know, persons in the Constitution, we can safely assume meant humans. But it doesn't say that, okay? It doesn't say that. It just says persons. So we have this legal fiction that is created basically to do contracts and sue or be sued and basically do business, right? All property. Now, when the founders wrote our Constitution, they were very wary of these corporations. So they allocated power. And on the We the People side, they made us, well, us, the sort of loose us, okay? We had rights, we were sovereign, and we were private. On the other side, because we didn't trust government, we wanted to keep a rein on that, and we wanted to keep a rein on the corporations. So we held government and corporations accountable to We the People, and very public, the books were public, everything was public through the state legislature, and it was tasked with duties. Pretty much corporations were, for a limited time only, for a very specific purpose, building a canal, public purpose, public good, okay? Building a canal, building a bridge, whatever, and as soon as that project was done, then I think we could have the lights up a little bit, because I don't want to lose you guys. And this is all not oil spill stuff, so you can see it a little easier, I think, with the lights on. Yeah? Oh, whoa, that's okay. That's a little too much. There, let's try it. Well, who was there? Okay, well, all right. At least you're all more awake now, right? All right, so we have this, we allocated power this way. All right, okay. Corporations, and then they were disbanded when they had done their public job. Thank you very much. Here's your share of the profit. Gone. Okay, so. Okay, the blurring of rights started pretty much after the ink was dry on the Constitution. Corporations, the first 100 years or so after the Constitution was passed, started agitating for more privileges through the state legislature. So now we're getting limited liability and in perpetuity and no place base anymore. So more and more privileges are going to these artificial persons. The second 100 years, and this isn't exactly, you know, 100, but we're roughly these phases, the courts started doling out not privileges, but rights. And now we're in the phase we're in now, which is where the corporations are just simply taking global rights through trade agreements. Now, Thomas Jefferson saw this coming. Other founders saw it coming, too. When you create something, you know what its strengths are, you know what its weaknesses are. All right? 1819 was the first time that the Supreme Court found corporations in the Constitution, which does not mention corporations. So Thomas Jefferson said in 1821, our country is now taking so steady a course as to show by what road it will pass to destruction, to wit, by consolidation of power first, and then by corruption, its necessary consequence. The engine of consolidation will be the federal judiciary. The second, the other two branches, the corrupting and corrupted instruments. The engine of consolidation will be the federal judiciary. I did not know there were two ways to amend the Constitution. One through people-made law, through us, which is what we're doing here, agitating civil war, you know, abolitionists, suffragettes, and one through the federal judiciary, through the Supreme Court, through interpretation of the law.